Okay, next up we have Kelsey Kennedy. Kelsey is originally from the US and came to Perth to pursue a PhD after completing her bachelor's degree in mechanical engineering in Indiana. At UWA, she's a PhD student within the Optical and Biomedical Engineering Laboratory. Her thesis title is Development of Optical Coherence Elastography Toward Guidance of Breast Cancer Surgery. And her three-minute thesis title is Feeling for Cancer, an Imaging Tool to Make Breast Cancer Surgery More Effective.
For many women, it starts when they feel a suspicious lump during a self-exam. Then comes a trip to the doctor, and for some, the dreaded news, you've been diagnosed with breast cancer. Now, many of these women will have one or both breasts completely removed, but there is another option. Most of these women could opt to have breast conserving surgery. Now, this is where only the tumor is removed, along with the surrounding margin of healthy tissue, and the rest of the breast is spared. Now, this seems like the more attractive option, right? But there's a catch. Because for breast conserving surgery to work, all of the tumor must be completely removed. And if I'm a surgeon, I'm trying to cut just around the boundaries of your tumor to within a couple of millimeters. And in one out of every four of those surgeries, I'm going to leave a little bit behind. And I'm going to have to call my patient and say, I'm sorry, we didn't get it all. You're going to have to come back in for a second surgery. Now, the main way that surgeons currently find the boundaries of this tumor is by feeling for the cancer, much like the way the woman originally felt a lump in her breast. But while we may often think of tumors as being these hard objects, the actual structure of a breast tumor is very complex. It has these tentacle-like structures that grow out into the breast tissue. And some of these small extensions of cancer can be fractions of a millimeter in size, just too small to detect through human touch alone. So I want to come up with a tool that surgeons can use during surgery to find the precise boundaries of the tumor and cut in the right place the first time. Now, we've actually come up with a way to do this. We've taken a microscope, which can see even these small extensions of cancer, and we've miniaturized the optics to fit inside a needle. Now, surgeons can use this microscope and a needle during surgery, insert it into the tissue to see if there's any cancer in a particular area. We're working with surgeons here in Perth right now to test this idea, and so far we have been able to see some of the tumor boundaries. But we've also noticed a problem. And that's that when you insert a needle into tissue, the tissue actually deforms around the needle quite a lot. And that's distorting our images. But rather than let that confound the idea, I'm trying to come up with a way to measure that deformation. Because we know that cancer feels different, often harder, than the normal tissue. So I think that cancer will be deforming differently in our images than the normal healthy tissue. So now, our microscope and a needle will not only be looking for the cancer, but feeling for the cancer as well. And with that information in the hands of a surgeon, we just might be able to make breast conserving surgery more effective the first time around. Thank you.